June 2014. Flying over remote Utah desert, eyes in the sky capture this image.
This is crazy. In the middle of what looks to be nowhere, there's a very purposeful pattern.
Further images reveal yet more unusual shapes in the desert scrub below.
These patterns come in different shapes and sizes.
There's one that looks like a big ice cube tray. One kind of looks like a wagon wheel.
So what possible purpose could be served by creating these patterns on the desert in close proximity to one another?
Analysts consider if the shapes are a legacy of the indigenous tribes who once ruled these lands.
This area was inhabited by tribes of the Navajo Nation, and they used numerous symbols in their culture.
Elsewhere, giant symbols have been found carved into the earth. Some are believed to have had a magical function, possibly a form of prayer or an attempt to communicate with gods who inhabit the skies.
Some of these symbols were for protection, some of them were for life-giving, and some were for luck. So I'm wondering, maybe the things we're seeing here could be Native American symbols.
Yet studies of Utah's indigenous peoples suggest the strange patterns aren't some kind of ancient code.
It's unlikely because they usually put their symbols into rock faces, not on the ground.
Military journalist Carlo Munoz suspects the patterns may have a sinister purpose and is traveling to the remote site to investigate.
Where we're driving right now, we're near one of the U.S. government's most important sort of training grounds for chemical and biological weapons.
Munoz knows that experimental military testing takes many forms and can leave long-lasting scars on the landscape.
There's got to be some sort of connection. I just can't put my finger on exactly what that could be.
One notorious Utah base could help shed some light.
It's entirely possible that these symbols are connected to the Dugway Proving Ground. The operations that go on at Dugway are really top secret. I mean, these are the types of operations that you would put maybe on par with something going on at Area 51.
Declassified records confirm Dugway scientists have been conducting clandestine bioweapons experiments in the Utah desert for almost 80 years. These include trialing the aerial dispersal of VX gas, weaponized mosquitoes, and fleas infected with the bubonic plague. Dugway's aerial experiments here remain some of the most controversial in U.S. military history.
With the high level of activity at Dugway Proving Ground, it's quite possible that these shapes are related to what's going on there.
Could they be targets? Could they be some sort of, you know, side effect of some of these tests? I don't know, but we're going to go see what's happening out there.
The desert road stops long before the shapes begin.
All right. This looks about as far as I'm going to be able to go.
Munoz approaches the location indicated by the aerial images, but finding them isn't easy.
You know, you look at the satellite image, the symbol just pops out. But here on the ground, I mean, seeing what I'm seeing, I could be standing right on top of it, not even know. What? I think this is it. You have two paths going this way. You turn here, you have the same exact sort of pattern here. Turn again, and it's there again. So this is probably the center of it.
From the ground, the symbol lacks the precision visible from the air. Whatever this is, Munoz doesn't think military testing can explain it.
I'm not seeing any signs of any type of military activity. There's no craters or whatnot. So this is clearly not some kind of extension of a military base.
The desert floor yields some clues.
This is all loose sand, as long as I've been walking. But coming down here, looking down this path, this is packed down. This is almost designed to take a very heavy weight.
The shape is huge. Munoz reckons 12,000 square feet. The plant growth suggests it may be decades old.
Whoever built this thing, they built it to last. Why would someone do that? What makes it even weirder is we know that there are several other symbols out here just as big.
Munoz thinks the shapes nearby must be connected.
That symbol may have been similar to something like the X on a treasure map. Now the question is, what exactly were they looking for?
Munoz turns to aerial images for help. To the north, he spots what could be a small abandoned mine.
If I can figure out what exactly they were mining out of this old mine, hopefully I can figure out what these symbols out here are for.
Munoz sets out further into Utah's perilous desert. It was not until the late 18th century that Europeans dared to explore these arid lands.
There it is.
Beyond the mining huts, Munoz spots an entrance into the rock face.
This is the mine, but it looks like we're a little barred off here. It's not gonna be able to get in.
This can't be a gold mine. The nearest known deposits of gold lie far to the north and east of here.
If you take a look, look how far that goes into the rock face. I've heard of mines like this, kind of carved right into rock. And it could be a uranium mine.